Hi guys, this is Jason here from the Nathaniel School of Music, and in this bass lesson, we are going to talk all about intervals, the building blocks of music as we know it. For a bass player, intervals are extremely helpful because they can allow you to form some great bass riffs, which are very unique and creative. It will allow you to decipher and play through chord progressions. Also to improvise melodically, to create some great melodic phrases or great passing phrases as you go along, right? So before we get started, perhaps you'd want to turn on that subscribe button if you haven't already, and maybe turn on the bell icon for notifications. Please do that. Thanks. So let's get started right away. I'm going to use E for pretty much the whole video, but intervals are relative. So that means you could use this concept starting with any note of the bass guitar. So I'm going to start with E on the A string. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The 7th fret of the A string. So all of our intervals are going to be formed and built around this E. And the way the lesson's going to flow is I'm going to first cover the intervals which you're going to use very often in your riff making or bass playing. And then we'll move into other intervals which are more passing intervals. And then we'll move into the growly or the scary or the tension intervals. And also look at a few mysterious sounds along the way. Music doesn't have a lot of notes to deal with. It's just 12 notes. So as long as you get that under your radar, you can actually try. All you then need to do is figure out where to find them and also how to use them, which is also important. And the instrument, the bass or the bass guitar as I am playing, is really, really cool for forming intervals, because from anywhere you go or from any point on the guitar or the bass, as we call it, you can form the same intervals the same way. So you can literally close your eyes and play these intervals. Okay, so let's get started right away. You have E again, okay, which you could play. And the first interval which I'd like you guys to figure out is the octave. So the octave is from here. You could use your pinky. Okay, is that clear? I hope so. I hope that's clear. So you go E and E. So the idea is you skip a string, skip two frets, go two frets up and play that. Right? You could work on that. Octaves are very cool for all your bass lines. You can obviously change the chords around or the notes around. It's still going to be E and E's octave, which is E. In this case, D and D's octave, which is D. And in this case, C and C's octave, which is C. So I finished octaves. Now we can look at forming the fifth. Okay. E, B, E, B. So even if you don't know that that note is in fact B, maybe your music theory is a little here and there, you could just find a fifth or a perfect fifth, as we call it, from anywhere by going up to the next string and going up two frets. So you go E, next string, up two frets, B. E, up to B, E, B, E, B. And what you'd also want to consider is also to try and figure out the lower fifth. The lower fifth is super easy. If you want to go lower, you go down the string to the previous string. E, B, E, B. So you see the pitch is the same, right? Because they are octaves of each other. So you go E, B, E, B, E, B, E, B. So let's do E, B, E, B, E, B, E. Of course, that's a low E. So you go E, B, E, B, E, B, E. Okay? So that's your fifth and octave. Very, very important. Another thing you guys could also do, you know, is if you go to E on the 12th fret of the E string, you know, you can actually play it with your pinky and get the same intervals. It's a little tricky, so I'd advise you to perhaps do the old version, and now you can try the other option. So you get E, E, and then B. That's the fifth. E, B, E, B, E. So if you prefer to play it from the pinky position, E, B, E, B, E. Root, perfect fifth, octave, perfect fifth, E, which is back to the root. Okay, so let's, for the most part, stick with this position, but just know that you can also start with the pinky finger position. Okay, so you go, I'm coming back to E. Let's revise. E, B, E, B, E. Right, if you have your bass, you should ideally play along with me. If you don't, no problem, you could follow along. So you go E, B, E, B, E, B, lower B. Very important intervals, what we call as resolutions. Another interval which is called as a resolution or stable, which you're going to use very often, is called as the third. Okay, so let's look at the two kinds of thirds. You have the major third. That's root third. How did I form that? I played E. Ideally, you could now play the E with your middle finger. Skip a string, go up. Not skip, rather go up and then go down the fret by one. So that's E, G sharp, which is its major third, or the third in the major scale. E, G sharp, E, G sharp, E, B. That's what we learned earlier, the fifth. E, G sharp, E, B, E, G sharp, E, B. Pum, 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 pum. Okay, so if your middle finger is playing E, then your G sharp could be played with your index finger. However, if your index finger chooses to play E, then your G sharp could be found here, or your major third could be found here. Got it? Right? It's a little bit more of a stretch, but depends on the music you play, depends on the pattern. So you may want to learn this third. So this third is actually on the same string, where you skip 1, 2, 3, and then play the fourth fret after skipping 3 frets. Tum, pum, pum. So that's the third. See, it sounds exactly the same, right? E's third, E's third, which is still the G sharp. Okay, so that's your third interval. And again, if you start from here, you could also form it here. Okay, from your pinky. If you like your pinky shape, you could probably play it from the pinky and maybe the middle finger. So that's your major third. And major thirds are generally emotionally very positive and sort of bright sounding compared to the other third which I'm going to show you, which is called as the minor third, right? That's the little sadder or a little bit more pensive or a little bit more, a little bit more gloomy, okay? So I have E. To form the minor third, what you do is you can first of all go to the next string and then play here. So next string, go down a fret, or rather two frets if you count 1, 1, 2. So 1 minor third, E minor third, which happens to be the note G, by the way. E, G. So you could do something like E, G, E, B. Come back to the fifth. So you're actually building grooves with just pretty much these intervals. Pum, 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 pum. That's the minor third. So if you play the minor third this way, I guess you should start with your pinky or your ring or your middle finger. Then you can play the minor third up here or down here with your index. If you choose to start with your index finger, or the first finger as we call it, it's actually a little easier. Then you do index, pinky, index, pinky. Root, minor third, root, pum, 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 pum. Right? And it's also important to figure out, okay, now that you've got your minor third, also hunt or have a playing field where you also know where your perfect fifth, which we learned earlier, and your octave is, which we also learned earlier. So you do E, G, B, right? So my fifth is there. If I'm in this shape, E, G, B, E, which is the octave. Dum, pum, 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 pum. Or E, G, E, B, E, G, E, B. If you want to do the lower fifth, right? Or if you're here, E, G, E, G, B, E. E, G, E, G, B, E. Or the same thing goes with major thirds. Pum, 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 pum. Right? If you like playing this major third, you can do a nice slide, because anyway, it's tough to get there. So I guess that'll work out in your favor. You've built a nice groove there. So far, we've learnt the resolutions on the bass, or the intervals which are sort of go-to. You know, whenever you're jamming with a song, following a chord pattern. So you take the chord. The chord, if it's a major chord, you could find the major third. Because a major chord is the root, major third, and the fifth. And of course, the octave you can add as well. If you're looking at a minor chord, it's going to be the root, the minor third, and the fifth. So anytime in your song or in your chord chart where you might find a major chord, you could play the root, major third, perfect fifth for the major chord. And whenever you find a minor chord, you could play the root, the minor third, and the perfect fifth. In the next part, we are going to do the anticipations. Okay, wherein you're going to color up your fretboard or your fretboard knowledge even more by adding other notes which then tend to pass by or tend to lead to the resolutions which we've already learned today. So let's conclude. We've learned the root, we've learned the perfect fifth, we've learned the octave on the bass. Then we've learned the major third and the minor third, which add that strong emotional vibe which you get, right? So I hope you guys found this lesson useful, and do make sure to head over to the next lesson as well. And also head over to our music theory section of our YouTube channel. And as always, do not forget to subscribe, turn on that bell icon for notifications whenever we do send you new updates to our lessons. And do share our channel, like, blah, 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 all of those nice things. Yeah, I will see you in the next lesson.